I don't remember actually how I came across this story. Might have been I read it in the news or somewhere. But once I picked up this story, I proposed it to my colleagues, my classmates back then. So I spoke to Robin and to Daniel. They kind of liked it, and those guys actually liking the ideas I proposed to them, and we decided to go ahead. And after school, after uni, after we wrote this dissertation, we decided to go ahead and actually shoot the movie. We didn't even have an idea how to start. And obviously the main interview is with Opitz, and we had to secure that one. Back then we had help from Timi Valo. She's a journalist in Bulgarian national television. And she really helped us a lot finding Vladimir, securing interview with Markovsky. But what she told me is to forget about topics. She didn't believe that we were able to secure this interview just because this guy, since he was in prison, he never spoke to the media. Of course, the first time we went to this prison, we had to speak to the director, we met Opitz. What I promised to him is not to talk about the case. I promised to him to talk about the Bulgarian iconography as an art form. That was our agreement. After that, we wrote an official letter to the Bulgarian Ministry of Justice and asked them permission to film in the prison. They gave us three rules as well: not to talk about the case, not to film other prisoners, and to obey the rules in the prison. We didn't film other prisoners, and we obeyed the rules, but we did talk about only about the case. And it wasn't my pushing forward this conversation. It was actually Opitz who really wanted to talk about it. The reenactments were divided by two major parts. One part was where actually the story was happening, where actually everything was happening, next to Opitz's block of flat, actually inside of his block of flats. And so we were filming there for the good one day, and then in the evening we went to this mountain again to film the drug scenes. The drug scenes, they went quite well. And then again, we had the pistol scenes, which we filmed in my grandparents' garage. This documentary gave us experience, taught us a lot, because it's not... I mean, even with this romantic view, when you came up straight from film school, and when you go to the real world and start filming, it's not what you expected. It's nothing what you expected. It's a completely different animal. So I believe myself and my colleagues too. It was a great experience, and just taught us a lot. And hopefully the next project, we're gonna learn from our mistakes, created in a better way, more cinematic, more reenactment-y, or depends on the project, of course. But we can definitely make it better.